That. It always says that.
Does it really?
Yeah, it's the Twitter problem, but
all right.
So we are now officially live, and it's yeah, Mystery's first time on Periscope, like in a structured kind of way.
It's the first time I'm with you on Periscope.
But that's all that counts, right?
That's all that counts, exactly. The last time was Poland. I was hanging out with our buddy, Baxter.
Oh, nice.
Right, that was the last time, and then I got busy hiding from the world. And
so
now I'm back in the swing of things, I guess you could say. Right, I've been working for.
So, by the way, they're interacting with you right now. So these are the comments
cool.
from the guys.
Good.
The hearts, funny, just for education, for mystery. Not that I would educate you, but for the guys, the hearts is the currency. This is your appreciation of what's happening on. It's letting us know that you're nodding your head. It's making sense what we're sharing. First of all, welcome Mystery, the world's number one pickup artist, my mentor in the game. Have a lot to thank you for.
Yeah, and IU.
There you go.
No doubt.
Jules Alexandra, hey, Mr. You haven't killed myself. My game works. There you go. So, guys, this is very informal. It's very relaxed. You guys get to join in. Mr. doesn't know you. For those of you who follow me a lot, just say your first name, because rather than your name being FRKDG, which means nothing, tell us your name and which city you are dialing in from. And that way, Mystery knows where you are. It also tells other guys who are interested in the game, pickup, dating, seduction, who you are and where you are, and you've got yourselves immediate wingmen. So make sure you follow each other. On that note, make sure you follow, because this Periscope will be live for 24 hours. And we're going to be doing another one. Hey, Baxter, our master pickup artist friend in the background.
Baxter in the house.
Chris from Manchester. Manny,
pleasure,
DC.
Gentlemen. Pleasure. Fun.
So, by the way, before we get in really quickly, to make sure
great
your
hear.
Wingmen get
fellow
this,
Canadian.
If you're on an iPhone, you want to be swiping from left to right now and clicking share. I'll give a shout out to anyone who shares, because that means everybody else is getting this. It's only live for 24 hours. Make sure you follow as well, because then tomorrow when Misty and I do the next one, and we've got some big announcements tomorrow, then it'll make sure you'll get a fast announcement via Twitter. So
that's sort of how we're going to break it down then, is today it's going to be a shorter gathering, right? And then tomorrow we're going to have much more time to actually get to the secrets that we wanted to reveal.
Exactly.
So we're not going to reveal them today, are we?
No.
But we are going to reveal them on the very
tomorrow,
next time.
Tomorrow.
Good stuff. Okay.
May I draw your attention to this? This is our group on Facebook. So for those of you, it's called 3 Second Rule. It's nice and simple. And for those of you, there you go, Duncan, thank you for sharing with your followers. For those of you who don't get your questions answered by Mystery live today, make sure you post them on the 3 Second Rule group. Then we can read them in our leisure tomorrow and make sure we'll fill them in. We will get back to everyone who puts questions on there. They'll get answered. It might not be in its entirety, but they will get answered. Who the hell is this? Okay, a lot of
that
you guys, if you don't know what we're talking about, go back to the title and read the fucking thing. Okay, fair? So, Mystery, welcome. Who's got questions for Mystery? I'll be going back and forth online and having a check. And then
fair. Well, while people are gathering their thoughts and putting them into words and sending them our way, just to quickly catch you guys up, because it may have been a while. Over the last couple of months, now this adventure of mine, I've been away from Toronto now for a couple of months, and it began with you coming to Toronto when it was fucking freezing, right?
I bought a nice big coat.
And a boot camp happened that weekend. Some training took place, right? It got me out of the house and started me off on an adventure that I'm still on, that we're still on, really. You know, we've separated and come back a couple times now, right? So from Toronto, I went with Baxter to Madrid, Spain. And we met up with a gentleman by the name of Alvaro Reyes. And he's a day gamer.
Oh, okay.
And
gay
game.
That's what I call a gay game, you know.
The bonus rounds of day game. He has, I would say, quite literally mastered the art of direct game. Right?
Nice.
That's what Alvaro has done. And from there, in learning some of the day game stuff, I brought it with me, because I don't just do night game, I also do day game.
Mm-hmm.
It's,
as we've seen.
Right? It has nothing to do with where the sun is. It has to do with the energy levels, and the universe presents an opportunity. Do you meet it halfway or not? It happens sometimes in the day. So I took the information of that and integrated it into the adventure that led to Barcelona. And Barcelona is filled with a lot of women. What story do I want to zoom into here? Actually, I just want to, I'm going to shorten this one up and say that I got my teeth done. What do you think, guys?
He says he was there. Danny says he was there.
Okay, fair enough. Hey, man. And I got them done. Anyone who knew I didn't have them done at the time, there they are. I'm feeling great. The pain is gone. That's my personal update. And then from Barcelona, I went with Baxter to Helsinki. And it was in Helsinki that we did a 3-day seminar that for several students continued on via boat to the next lecture, or what we call a boot camp, PUA boot camp, because it's not just seminar in the day, it's also bringing the boys out into live pickup scenarios, live environments, target-rich venues is really what I wanted to say. And some of the guys came with us for non-stop, action-packed 10 days of every night infield experience, every day, day game, and all the seminar components all over the course of 10 days. And I think it was quite an extraordinary way of training, what we'd called evolve immersion. And we have immersed or flooded quite a few new men and brought them into this game. Tom's saying bye. Okay, cheers, brother. Thanks for popping in. Do tune in tomorrow because we do have some additional news that we're going to drop. Is gaming still your passion? It's become my passion again, no doubt. Do I have different goals? I have the same goals. I still have a pursuit. My magnificent obsession is the pickup arts. I do love it. We went out last night. I mean, I had to, you know.
You dragged me out.
Right? And while we did not abide by the 3-second rule, because it wasn't expected, we came, we got there, right? And it was way across the bar. I felt like we didn't wreck the set, you know, for opening it. And then we just went across and opened that set. I did it for fun. That's the point. Is there's something really rewarding. There's something rewarding in doing a set that results in smiles and laughter and good times.
Definitely.
You know, it's like you're creating a moment, you're creating a magical moment. And so, yeah, I'm still very much dedicated to that as an art form. Over the last couple months, I've come up with some new material. I've come up with some new understandings, you could say. My inner game and outer game ideas have sort of dovetailed a lot more nicely. Hey, man.
Love Street.
Love Street. Love the name. and back to me. So from Helsinki, boating to Sweden, to Stockholm specifically, we did another boot camp. Now remember, each night is an adventure, is an event. Traumatizing event, right? And now the two of us, we've had this debate going today, and it started yesterday. The idea, and I'm agreeing with you on this, okay? But the idea is quite simple. I believe that if you traumatize yourself, if you can have a trauma-based learning experience, then you'll be able to take that traumatic experience, you know, such as doing a dozen sets a night for you know, a long weekend, or, you know, better, I was going to say worse, or more traumatic for 10 days straight. Now, talk about flooding. Cheers to that. And yet, discovery side, and I'm going to agree with this, is to minimize their trauma. So what I think is maximize the traumatic experience in its intensity when you're prepared for it. In other words, get out of the fucking house, with respect, and start gaming again. Do you need me to tell you it's game time? It is spring. It is time to get out of the house and interact with your fellow humanity. The women are out there. It's been the first warm day since you arrived.
And I know, it's been the sunshine.
He brought the weather. And we should be taking full advantage of that, right? So now summertime's coming, and even in the fall, there are a lot of different places on this planet that are just gorgeous, where the women are looking for men. There are single women looking for men. Mm-hmm. And what we can do is we can choose various cities around the world, go there, and use the venue as a positive learning experience, as a practice grounds for a time when a woman of particular quality comes along in the future. You know, you'll have the skill set to get her. That's the idea. And a thought that I have shared, this is a few weeks back now, but I had shared this thought that I believe in quite strongly, and that is, I'd rather fail with the 10 than succeed with the 6.
Yeah.
So if you're going to practice, if you're going to train, if you've decided, I'm going to get good at this, you know, if it takes six weeks of intense training, of just every night going out, or at least going out more than you stay home, which is what the newbie mission's about, you know, going out 4 nights a week, stay home 3. Stay home when you have a date, right? If you're single and you don't have a girl at home, well, you're going out tonight. It's as simple as that. And what are you doing next week, Tuesday? Well, you're going out Tuesday. Why Tuesday? It's not a great night to go out. Well, it turns out it's a great night to find a girl that is not into the club scene. Hey, you know, you're going to reach out and find some other types of people as well on different nights. Right, so do you agree with that idea?
The Absolutely. Idea of, I mean,
of trauma?
The trauma and the reality is the people who learn comfortably and you're doing exactly what's within your comfort range and a little bit beyond that, then True. You're going to grow slowly, is the reality. Anybody who makes themselves really uncomfortable, okay, when you get really uncomfortable, okay, like if you stand and observe the sets and you don't approach, okay, then you stay comfortable. But you don't grow from being uncomfortable. You grow from being uncomfortable. Like going to the gym. You stretch your tether muscles for them to grow stronger. And if you go to the gym once every few weeks, you're going to get a little return. And a lot of guys get into the game, come by, this doesn't work, that doesn't work. It all works. It's your job to make it work. If we can make a routine or a system or a structure work for us, if Bex is doing it and other masters out there, then, and if it's not working for you, there's something you're not doing right. Most of the time, it's putting yourselves in the most uncomfortable positions, because that which is most uncomfortable, you will psychologically want to move away from your unconscious and your conscious actions. And if you can do a lot of the same repetitive exercises that get you in uncomfortable scenarios, then by default, you'll become more comfortable with those scenarios.
You'll
grow fast.
You'll grow.
But if you drag it out over years, if you're the kind of guy who wants to open 100 sets over a year, your growth, you'll always be uncomfortable and you'll blame the system.
You can do 100 sets in a couple weeks, really. If you do
And from that, boom, you desensitize faster. So then the 3-second rule is not a problem. You're desensitized. But the guys were growing slowly. So I do agree with get uncomfortable. And if, for instance, you don't like opening seated sets or mixed sets, then go do more of that.
Yes.
Not occasionally, but immerse yourself for a shorter time frame.
Yesterday's set, I would not have gotten that girl's contact information were it not for the fact that I recognize that men are just ugly girls. And I went in and worked the mixed set anyway.
Yeah.
You Bex, know, anyway, I'm going to go do it anyway.
And Bex made a nice little quote there.
What did he say?
If you always do what you've always done, you'll always get what you've always got.
Right. Yeah. And you don't have to wait for the perfect scenario to open. Just open. You don't know how it's going to unfold. That's half the fun, is to go in, find out what not to do. You'll learn what to do over time, right? If enough pathways of what not to do are revealed, the pathway of what you should do will reveal itself for the next day.
Well, let's look at some of your questions are coming in live
awesome.
Right
Thanks,
now.
Guys. Great fun.
So again, if you're appreciating and you're liking and it's making sense to you and you appreciate Mystery just being here, pump the screen, guys, share the hearts, and make sure you click on share. If you're just joining us and you're in replay or joining us halfway through,
Mystery,
make sure you follow
Discover
the world's best pickup artist and wingman.
Mom is so proud.
There you go. So a couple of the questions. One of the guys, can you give some examples of push-pull? Maybe a definition.
Examples of push-pull.
Or maybe okay. a definition of what it is.
Fair enough. The idea of hitting on a girl and then when she feels discomfort, pushing you away and then you waiting a beat and then hitting on her again and then she pushes you away is very much like man hands. Has this ever happened? You know, you go to grab a girl's breast, perhaps in S3, you know, this isn't your opener, but you know, you've gotten a girl in isolation, as in C3, your living room, or hers, and you go like this, and she goes, and so you think, well, I'll just wait a beat, let's bring it back, right, let's kiss her some more, and she goes, and you think, how am I going to do this, oh, I got it. No. This is like a push and a pull happening, but it's happening on her end, right? That's a push-pull, isn't it?
Yeah.
But you're the one doing the pushing, and then she's sort of pushing you away, and then you're pushing, and she kind of gives you the negative response that you sort of either ignore or just wait a beat before working again. And again, and this is push, push, pull, push, push, pull, push, push, pull, right? So,
2 steps forward, 1 step back.
But that is still under push, pull, right? Because there is a push happening and a pull happening, but the intensity of which is happening is what people don't really look into. So, what I like to do is known as push, pull, pull. Yes, I will make the move on the girl, for instance, taking your hand and putting it on her knee. You can do that. But then what happens when she feels discomfort, she'll take your hand and push it away, take it off of your knee. Right? And so you've now been pushed off. What I'd rather do is grab her hand, put it on my knee and say, that's all you get, and hold my hand on top of hers for a beat and then continue the conversation. And at some point, you know, for instance, you could say, can you cook? No? Oh, well, you're losing me. And you're just saying something, anything that allows you to now disqualify her from being a potential suitor, right? Because it is an egg where you're just sort of doing this. But the power of this, the power of any keynote escalation, the power of any of that, of making a move, is in the roll-off. And I'll say that again. The power of any keynote escalation is in the roll-off.
The release.
The release. That's the power, right? And so it isn't push, pull, push, pull, push, pull, push, pull throughout the whole thing, which is just erratic, but rather it's push a little bit and then pull before. Mm. You know, the idea is if you're hugging a girl and she starts tensing up and there's some discomfort, well, then you're going to release. But you're going to release and then, for a beat, ignore. It's actually going to be a roll-off where you roll off and say to someone else, oh, by the way, and you're not all leeching on the girl, right? So it's 1 step forward, make the move, and then release, but release even more so where she's now going to have to regain your attention.
Because you're releasing your attention before span. She releases.
That's exactly it. And then going that one extra step so that there's this strange void, this void that needs to be filled. Wow, he was touching me, but now he's not touching me.
Now she's going to chase, and that's important,
that's
guys.
That's exactly it. It's
you're setting the tone. There's two big guys in there as chasers in the relationship, but they were groomed and trained on her terms right at the beginning.
It's the gift of the chase, and every single pickup should be like that. The idea isn't push, pull, push, pull, push, pull, or push, push, pull, push, push, pull. A lot of dudes just go push, push, pull, push, push, pull, right? That is being all man-handsy. It's very uncomfortable for any woman to have to endure that type of approach. Instead, push, do make a move, and then pull so that she feels that discomfort and that need to touch you to make the move again. So you, within that vacuum, within that void of your doing a takeaway or what was the word you used?
Not release.
A release, exactly. Big hook, real release. in doing that, she then meets you. She then will make a move, and then you accept that, and then take that away, and she makes a move, and then you accept that, and then take it away. And so she ends up being sucked towards you, and every single set, like in every set, your target should be chasing you. I don't know if you know that, but it really is the best game plan.
Feels great.
Yeah, it's the best game plan that you could possibly have. It feels good, it's self-validating, and it's the way.
Remember, men, this is like based on evolutionary psychology, the basics is men weren't designed to be the chasers, okay? They weren't to be the leaders. And mm-hmm. we don't mind putting a hunt time in, but if you keep chasing all the way and she's pushing you off and you keep chasing even more, what happens is you may end up getting into the relationship, but you are in the position of now being the chaser. She's calling out all the shots. And eventually, even though you love each other, you're connected. You might even get engaged. The amount of times I've seen friends as marriage break down because they're just, and you speak to the woman, what was going on? And I just don't know. It doesn't feel the same. Why? Because she groomed him from day one to be chasing, and he just got into the role of being a chaser. Yeah. Now, eventually, she's in the relationship with him, and she's getting less and less attracted to him because he's not being the very thing that she evolutionarily wants, which is being the leader.
Right. It's like creating, it's like behaving in a way that you think is going to work to get her because she said that's what she likes. So you behave that way. And then what a woman says she wants and what she responds to are oftentimes two entirely different things. So you have to give her the gift of the challenge. You have to give her the gift of the chase, right? And if you don't do that, even in a relationship, this is, you know, in my opinion, and I could be wrong because my relationships have been just haywire, right? Aside from that, you know, like I think I'm very good at courtship, you know, from meet to beginning a sexual relationship, right? From here to here. But then there's the relationship management, and yes, many of the tools in courtship that we use are useful in relationship management, but I don't feel like I'm the expert. Yeah. You know, generally
I'm writing
there.
The R1 to R3 component in relationships.
Okay, there's R1, R2, R3.
Setting expectations, managing outcomes, having options,
and then there's the breakup, right?
Yeah, it's always a breakup.
B1, B2, B3.
Good model. Here's a thought as well. What I like about push-pull on, what I really like about a model, it's funny, I just had a guy whining saying, you know, we're evil towards women. We were just looking at a picture at how many books women have about how to get men, how to keep men, how to get to the day 2 days. There are about a handful of books for guys in the world. Mm. And the one thing I love about our model in the push-pull is rather than us being the guys keep pushing, trying to get something, we're an artist. We push a little bit, or we move forward a little bit, but then we release, we give her comfort in that release. Mm-hmm. We allow her to feel safe, so she's also in control, and that's really, really powerful. Rather than the guy keeps pushing and pushing and pushing, two steps forward, one step back. And I know this like from a military background. I had 10 years in the British Army, for those of you that know that. When you are laying down fire, you've got a guy who's undercover behind the wall, and you keep laying down fire, his head stays down. His head's not gonna pop his head off to get shot. So you must eventually stop firing to create the release for them to feel safe to pop the head back up. Then you can blow the head off.
Fair.
Crazy little metaphor there. But yeah.
War metaphor for love.
There you go. So that was a bit of push-pull. The best thing is not to just understand the concept, but there are great gambits that we teach that actually include naturally the push-pull mechanisms within our gambits. So it's not like you have to get the understanding, well, what do I do with that? Just get the right gambits, and we automatically include those. And we teach those on our boot camps.
Yeah, they're Kino gambits. Some of those are push-pull related.
Exactly.
Right? As are the use of indicators of interest and negs, or indicators of disinterest. We use them in what we call a micro-calibration, in a micro-calibrated manner, in order to keep a balance where your value is retained, mm-hmm. right? Because you can easily go in and say, for instance, I mean, the perfect example is buying a girl a drink. And one of two things can be a result of that. Either you get the girl, or you don't ever see her again and you lose a drink. So it all depends on where you are in the pickup. Sometimes I'll just buy the girl a drink. You know, mystery, you will? Yeah, on a day two.
They are different.
If she's taken the first round, will I? Yes, certainly. If she's Russian, right? I will.
But you're not buying the drink to get the girl.
That's exactly it.
It's natural social skills.
A Russian girl would know culturally that, of course, she's going to sit and for the time it takes to drink that, spend a moment with you, right?
Yeah, I didn't know that.
Yeah, that's the point of it, right? As long as they're not taking advantage of your group, right? Where they're coming in, all the girls are coming in and going, oh, buy us drinks. And you're like, oh, okay, well, hey, guys, let's all pitch in. Let's all buy these girls drinks. And then they go, okay, thanks, we're drunk now, bye. And they leave, right?
Push-pull like discoveries within Vegas. I'm not sure what that meant. But I'm sure there's a story there.
Oh, yeah,
my whip.
He lost his whip.
Oh, ah. No, my fajazzled.
Yeah.
Anyway. Next one. There's a little question I wanted to come to. A guy asks here.
That was a good one, too, regarding Negs. He always comes off as arrogant.
Who?
Forgive me. I didn't see that. Who just had said about the Negs?
He always comes off as arrogant.
Chris, there you go. Chris, thanks. You come off as arrogant. How do I come off?
You don't care, but it doesn't mean a big deal. You didn't do it to create a negative impact. And what I've seen in the last few years, you have a smile, there's a cheekiness to you and your playfulness, and it's like almost a tease at the same time. Mm-hmm. But basically, well, go on, you want to answer the question.
Well,
because I'm passionate about this one, so yeah.
Fair, but forgive me, what's the precise question?
His question was,
it makes him feel a bit arrogant.
He feels he's
coming across as arrogant. Well, how's this? Don't do that anymore. I certainly don't feel arrogant in any way. I feel self-amused. I'm self-amused by negs, you know? The point of a neg is to have a result of laughter, right? And comfort. They know you're not specifically after them, right? So perhaps I'll take a quick moment for some of you who maybe don't know what the word neg really means. It has nothing to do with insulting somebody. A neg is a statement or action one gives to briefly disqualify oneself from being considered a potential suitor. That's it. The girl's supposed to feel comfortable. The guys yesterday, the mix set, those guys left their girls with us.
They didn't have a choice, really, to be honest.
But how did that happen?
Let's not get into that story.
No, I'm just saying that they had allowed it to happen. So I had disarmed them, right? And how do we disarm the guys from thinking we're not specifically after these girls? Our body language, I think, had a great deal to do with it.
Pretty much our backs them at some point.
Exactly.
We were getting distracted by other people, you know?
Exactly. And so if for a moment we have our back to the target and her friend, and we're, you know, I ended up talking with some of the boys while you were working the two set of girls within that larger group. I ended up snagging three of them away for, I don't know, a good 10 minutes. That must have helped.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you know what I mean?
Disinterest.
And then those men were disarmed, so that going back into the feminine part of the mixed set was accepted, tolerated, permitted, allowed, right? What other words fit in for that? I think that's pretty
normal. It's just normal.
You're not after them. You're not creeping out the girls. You're just hanging out with the girls, you know?
So even though the guys were definitely not comfortable as being there because they'd been trying their asses off, they had bottles of champagne. They were buying and buying.
They were champagne. All the girls had champagne.
They were together, but they weren't. And it's great to see that come alive. I understand that guy's question about feeling arrogant. I got that my first year a lot.
Okay.
And I think it's because my delivery at the time, I knew the gambit, I knew what to say, and I was a confidence about me. Mm. But what I was missing was that my delivery at that time was missing playfulness. There was not that cheeky play. The playfulness that Baxter naturally has as a persona,
right.
I had to work at that. So my
too
first
much
year...
Maybe
yeah,
that's what it is.
Too much negging, but it was delivered
it was
delivered the same as it is now, but it had a coldness about it. I was saying it, and so our friends were like, wow, that was harsh. I'm like, really? Was it? And it's because there was a lack of expression of playfulness on my face at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
The streams and the others.
Fair enough.
So that makes sense on the next. Loads of questions. By the way, guys, a quick pointer. There were loads of questions flying in.
It's unfortunate. I'd love it if you could cut and paste and do some of those ones over again. Something
add
that was
them
based
on group.
Attraction.
So on the 3-second rule group now, if you keep adding your questions, then what will happen is tomorrow we'll look through those, we'll make a list, and then every time we come on the Periscope, we'll go through those questions. So rather than just pump them out right now, we might miss them, add them on the group, and we'll make sure we get to
Please.
Them either way.
That would be much appreciated. Mystery, is 5'3" out of the game? Yep, sorry, nobody who has no height, they're not allowed to have sex, so... nice meeting you. Goodbye. What kind of talk is that? It's not how tall you are, it's how tall you stand. And something that Neil talked about when he was wearing his elevator shoes, not that he got his taller than he is wife, he said the elevator shoes get some 3 more inches of woman. And he likes women. Don't you love women? You get 3 more inches of woman, isn't that worth it? So yeah, you'll be just fine. There are girls out there, even for you, little guy. Little man, you know. What's so funny is it's a little man can come into the club and can steal a tall girl away from a tall guy because he's still interesting, he's novel, maybe he's got some good DHV that hit.
One of the guys asked it's a good point, it's like, how there seems to be a fixation on the photo routine at the moment. How would you use that in modern day?
In modern day, the photo routine? Well, you could use Facebook. It's a matter of choosing what photos
so
you're
easy
using
these days.
On
so
Facebook.
Easy.
Printing them out still would have a value, I think, to people. You know, you could say, yeah, I had an instant camera, a little throwaway camera, and finally got around to developing these old photos. Check them out. And you have a dozen of them printed out, ready to go. I used to do it that way for a long time, even though I had a digital camera. In fact, when you go into a strip club or exotic dance club, we don't say strippers, they're dancers, of course. It's an art form. They really were compelled to want to pick up the photos that were seated on the table.
Yeah, they want to
grab. You know what I mean? And you're like, whoa, slow down there, man hands. You know, I don't go rifling through your purse when you go to the washroom.
Picture paints 1,000 words. Right.
So yeah, no, it's a wonderful routine, but I think the digital aspect of
but
it is it's
you
Facebook.
Used it yesterday. We were sat in TGI Friday. You were gaming the beautiful hot Swedish waitress.
Yes.
I had my girlfriend on there, and she was on she's on her own TV show at the moment. So
yeah, so he was showing me a poster that's on a bus, and I thought, hey, this girl who had mentioned that, you know, she wants to go to New York, and there was something actressy about her,
mm-hmm.
right? Very attractive. Young lady. And so I thought, ooh, since this is up, why not? Hey, you have to come and see this. And I just showed it. And she goes, oh, wow, cool. Now, why did I do that?
Because A1, you were showing value in the fact that your wingman in the set had a hot girlfriend.
That's
and she
famous.
Has high value, an actress. And that makes her feel safe. It wasn't two guys hitting on her.
That's
one
right.
guy's having a relationship, and he used that to his advantage. You know,
yeah.
So
and
I just been.
And I'd rather... You know, instead
let her see it rather than just talk about it.
Rather than interface with her this way, I'd rather sometimes interface with her.
Yeah.
It's me,
closer.
You know, it's
allows
me and the girl.
Touching, right?
It's
really?
Me and the girl against the universe, right? Rather than as if we're, you know, against
you
each other.
A
great question so far, though. This is
do you recommend indirect?
Yes, of course I recommend indirect. It is a good question. Thanks for leading it. You know, he's playing...
Let me say that I like that one. How do you not let girls trap you in a relationship? Trap you? Trap
I,
you?
I,
a man of
I,
choice
I,
get
I,
trapped?
I don't understand. Is this something that you're putting upon yourself? God is how to open a 2-set day game.
Approach?
Approach, yeah. Is
approach.
It a guy and a girl? Then tap them on the shoulders when they're kissing and say, may I cut in? You can do that. You can even...
With good delivery.
You can even say... I'm crazy!
He did.
Just to see how people respond, because really, it doesn't matter. Has anyone ever said that out in any public gathering? Did you do anything? The only thing you'll get are people yelling back, me too! That's all. That's what you can get away with.
How does direct work on a lone wolf? Indirect is indirect. Yeah.
But there's
you can of course. That's the art form. What I find funny is direct is a one note song. It's the removal of the art. It is directly going in and stating your interest, and then when she says the boyfriend, trying to handle that, right? As opposed to when you go indirect, she doesn't have to make a statement like that, you know? She doesn't have to, you're not forcing her to make a choice. You're not forcing her to make a decision on whether she should protect herself from you or not by saying, a protection statement like I have a boyfriend or I'm late for work, you know, or even just, you know, fuck off. If they're really hot and the girl thinks she's gonna have her time wasted by your approach and you're just the next guy or the last guy, then yeah, that's gonna be very dismissive. You know, a girl could be very dismissive. But when you go indirect, that's where you get maneuverability. That's where you can convey your personality and trigger attraction mechanisms prior to her need to decide whether she wants to stick around and hear you out or not. It's sort of beautiful that way. And you add in, you pepper in the negs, disqualify yourself for being considered a potential suitor. It buys you the opportunity to just slather on the DHVs. You DHV, DHV, neg, DHV, DHV, qualify. She starts qualifying, good. You know, IOI, you hook her for that. Reward her for the good behavior of qualifying. Here, come join me for a second.
Is the X-ray high?
X-ray bonger, sir.
From the Dutch Caribbean.
That's right, from Curaçao. Glad to see you are hanging out virtually with us. Good stuff. Hi, Giants.
It's only because you're on a little screen.
How big is your TV? That's what I say, you know, and sometimes I have to lick it and stick it to my eyeball. That's
one of the guys here, Daniel, Daniel Varela, add this one if you can, guys. How to maintain a healthy lifestyle, getting money and cool social circle of friends, and doing the game all at the same time.
Let's hold this one before this goes. Open relationship should you pretend to be single. I don't believe in lying at all. I'm a full-grown 44-year-old fucking man. I don't lie. I don't make shit up. My DHVs I've made are real. And I've collected them. I've accrued them over the many, many years of gaming and living my life and doing some crazy things that are worthy of telling stories about, right? Why lie? Some people lie about DHVs. So
you lie when you haven't got a choice.
Yeah.
Because you're scared of losing.
So what are you lying to her about? That you want to have a threesome? Go tell her. Will you lose the girl? You may. You may not. Right? But what you can do is tactfully tell a person. In a nutshell for me, I think if you are going to go into the next relationship, I don't even know who she is, but if I'm not ready to settle down and I'm not ready to be tied down, I'm not going to feel guilty by dating other girls. You know, I haven't expressly said to, say, the last girl that I'm planning on getting married to her, right, in the next week. So if you're in dating mode still, I think it's absolutely fine. Or maybe you want to get rid of your girl. Maybe you're unhappy. That was one of the other questions, so it's sort of similar. Mm. Is you're unhappy in a relationship and you want to play the game, but you're finding that the enemy of the best is the good.
Hey, guys.
Right? It's good to have a girlfriend. Forgive me, just to finish the thought. It's good to have a girlfriend, but it might be best to have a girlfriend you're actually attracted to. So sometimes you have to just exit your old life and start a new life.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. And what were we talking about? One of the things I got, when I got into the game, as I started getting good results, it's very hard not to get into relationships. If you're balanced and you've got good game skills, you'll find it very hard not to get into relationships. I didn't ever let relationships, okay, I toned it down. Maybe I was fucking every girl and moved, but I could go out with my girls at boot camp, still be a great wingman, polish even better, work on social skill sets, that because I was now pre-selected with a girl, I was safer, I could do so much more. So I was playing a different level game, which we all benefit.
It's almost like a different game itself.
But I never stopped gaming.
It's not cheating, by the way, to go out with a girl on your arm. That's not like, oh, I'm cheating. You know, you're not gaming cold approach. It's still game. You know, it's the five levels of game. Ultimately, you want to be able to invite all the girls that you've met over the last month, invite them to various venues, and surround yourself with beauty and women. You know, I get paid to not get laid. That's what it sort of boils down to in boot camp. Because we're surrounded by guys, you know, there's so many guys. And then to, within the context of the cock farm, to still be able to pick up, you know, that is an additional weight on my shoulders for training purposes, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Just like when my teeth were healing and I had some tooth problems, I was still picking up.
He was a whiner. We read the Facebook post.
I get weak. I get weak sometimes, tired and weak in these travels, and I have to vent to somebody. So I'm venting to you guys, and I appreciate you being there for it. You know?
Hey,
just to show you a rich range of emotion, because I don't.
Couple of us, the reason I'm staring at the screen, if you just join me, is that
we'll get around to it.
Facebook group 3 second rule. You guys can be posting your questions on there, and today and tomorrow we're going to be responding to those questions.
How to find it if none of you, if one of you isn't on it yet.
Actually,
here's how you get onto it. Go to your Facebook search engine, your search entry, and type in 3 second rule, all one word, and that should pop it up.
Yeah. And then exactly, facebook.com/groups/3second rule. What I want to quickly really hit here, because it's really quite simple. A lot of guys struggle to maintain balance, both in wealth, health, happiness, while they're doing the game. Let me put it straight. Well, there are 168 fucking hours in a week. Mm-hmm. Going to the gym to get into the habit is 3 of those hours. Are you telling me you can't afford 3 hours to look after your mechanism of delivery, your health? Okay? Now, the reason you can't find the time is because it's not a habit. Do you have to put in your diary brushing your teeth or wiping your ass? No, you don't. It just happens. So what you need to do, because there's a simple system of changing in anything life and to the game, but I'm talking about health here for a moment, is it takes 30 days to make or break any habit in life.
Mm-hmm.
If you can do something consistently, it's not how many times you go to the gym, it's can I get into the habit, and I'm going to lead somewhere on this in a moment, can I get into the habit of going a minimum of 2 days per week for the next 30 days? If you can build that habit just on going to the gym as an example, then it becomes a natural part of your habit. Now, if you want to do a few extra days on top of that, that's fine. People set themselves up for failure by saying, I'm going to try and go to the gym 5 days a week. But it's not a habit, going here, going there. No, write it in your diary, plan your work your plan, say 2 o'clock or 6 p.m. on a Monday and a Wednesday evening, I'm going to the gym. Like you'd have a dentist appointment, you put your alarm on for 30 minutes before to make sure you got your kids to take to work. And you plan it. Just like you would not miss your dentist appointment.
Just,
and if you treat it and value it like an appointment, like if you come to meet the man, you'd value it, and it's a habit.
Just like a student who is going to practice for football, right?
You've got to practice.
You have a schedule, and you practice. In pickup, I believe you should focus on practice. You actually have to practice for when a woman of quality comes along in the future. You're practicing for that. Right? When I was in my early 20s and found myself having my life rocked, and I was back with my living with my mother, and I remember going downtown and just meeting people just to do it, just to, because I knew I needed to. I needed to practice my magic that I was learning, and you can only do that in front of the man in the mirror so often before you have to actually get some live feedback. So, what was my point? Oh yeah, so what I'd say to her is, when she asked me, where are you going? I'd say, I'm going to practice. So are you going to practice? Are you practicing? I've been practicing. Oh, but you're mystery. Yeah, but I'm fucking mystery, so I better damn well practice, don't you think? Because if I'm gonna have to deliver the goods in front of a group of people at some point and pull that off, well, you know, my set is being cock farm compromised, right? If I'm going to be able to make that happen and show you and deliver the goods to actually see a mixed set and go, that's the set, and go, that's the girl, okay, I'm going to get that. That takes practice.
Practice.
That's what I'm saying.
Here's the thing, practice.
Okay,
yeah.
And to finish my thought here is what this is all about is the learning curve. focus on your learning curve. You have a learning curve, accelerate it, make it impactful, create a trauma for yourself. And I do augment my idea to, yes, have traumatic experiences, but don't live traumatically. Have your traumatic experiences so that you can shave off having to traumatize yourself constantly. Because you know what's more traumatic than doing a boot camp long weekend with some pro PUAs and getting a dozen sets under your belt a night? You know what's more traumatic than that? Not having a fucking game plan. What's that like, son? Hey, look at that, we're famous.
I'm actually using another Periscope account, yours, to actually type in the...
Oh, smart.
The 3-second rule group.
Smart but, stuff, just yeah, yeah, showing it's like that. It's like... Oh, did it... Oh, there we go.
So, that's kind of weird, isn't
we
it?
We see ourselves. Hey.
So the thing I wanted to say about the habits is...
Recursion.
Here's how you get time to get everything else in. Is a lot of guys get sucked into the game, and you go out for 5 or 6 hours, and you use a lot of time. And the reality is, when somebody's getting started, they might only do 5 or 6 sets in the whole night. Now, if you're not that great, your sets might last 2 minutes at best. Well, if it's 5 sets, that's 10 fucking minutes, mate. 10 minutes in a 5-hour period. What the hell are you doing for the rest of the time? So give yourself a time frame and say, look, I'm not going to go into the bars or the clubs because they're too loud. I'm going to get out a little bit earlier, 9 till 11. I'm out 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. And in that time, I'm doing a minimum 10 sets and I'm gone. And then if you're not fatigued the next day, get your ass out of bed and get down the gym. Get your ass out of bed after the gym or maybe an hour and read Robert Kiyosaki,
Robert Kiyosaki?
Yeah, Rich Dad, Poor Dad. How to grow your wealth. So you're working on your wealth, your health, you know.
And your relationships, yeah.
You know, your social skills. But it's all about time. But the problem is that anything is people drag it out. When I got into the game, I had a business that was struggling at the time. I was helping you guys on the sales and the program management. Mm-hmm. And I was traveling. I didn't have much time. So I got good on the back end of having 2 days in field. But you know what, those 2 days, I was out for 3 hours. That's all I was out. But in 3 hours, that was 20 sets. Yeah. Without fail. Yeah. Yeah, did I get blown? I got blown out more than any other guy. You know, on my first boot camp, when I was shitting myself, and everybody else knew about the book, The Game, and I hadn't really read it, and I felt really bad because I didn't know what a DHV was, and all these kind of geeky guys knew everything about everything.
Right.
And you know what? I thought, I've just flown around the fucking world to meet this guy in Chicago, and I thought, you know what? You remember you telling me, he's like, it's a numbers game. And I thought, I can do numbers. I'm not going to be good at it, but I can do numbers. I opened and failed on more sets than the entire infield 12 guys. But all they remember was that one girl coming back with me. They don't remember me and Ellie being in tears and freezing up.
As for the numbers game comment that you just made, the idea behind that is the more doors you knock on, the more will open, certainly. But it's all about learning curve. So the more doors you knock on, the more chances you have at figuring out which knock opens all the doors. So once you have that, then knock, 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 opens more doors than the hard knock, knock, knock one, right? But you have to learn it. You have to get out of the house, interact with groups of people, learn that they're approachable, and figure out systematically how to get yourself known and get yourself get them familiarized with your presence without telegraphing so much interest that it's going to make the AMOGs beef up and the target point at you and say, kill him, right? Which can happen in Vegas, so watch out for the 9s and 10s there. They have superpowers. They can have you, they can make you disappear and reappear inside of a hole in the middle of the desert. Who's 26? Are you 26 and you're a virgin? Like 26? Of course I recommend canned material, but the idea of the can is this is your can. It's in the can. You could write your own material. Go practice it. Automate it so that it's available to you when you need it. Just like Chris Rock, he's funny as all hell. Now, does he have a routine or two up his in his mind, especially a default opener or default routine if someone says, oh, you're a comedian? Does he have something to say? I don't know. Let's ask Chris Rock. Hey, Chris. He's not here right now. Though I did meet him. Touched his hand.
What you said about practicing before, a lot of times when we're not practicing to get the goal now the same night. We're practicing so we get the learning curve and the skills and the repetition. Mm-hmm. It's very hard for those of you who are going in field, say, I'm just going to go and be myself. Well, the reason you're trying to get to the next level is being yourself is not working, so we need to upgrade. It's like a new software programming. You know, you're trying to charge the new iPhone with an old Samsung cable. It's not working. So you need to upgrade the programming. That's why we bolt on some routines and gambits. Not so you become rigid and saying routines and sound bites. It's so you can get better at your delivery and how you say them. Mm-hmm. And that is the repetition that allows you to improve your delivery. And as you get better at the delivery, eventually, when the right girl, the one that's going to make a difference, the one who's going to be the future mother of your children, when she walks by, the habit of A, obeying the 3-second rule and approaching, the little sound bite in the opener that you've said a million times just rolls off your mouth. And by the way, don't fear that she's going to say, oh, you said this to me. A girl doesn't remember what you really said as your opener.
Yeah, it's an emotional impact.
She's remembering what your connection was about while you're in comfort, where you're sharing real life stories about who you are, the real value that you are as a man is coming through in your comfort material. All the banter and the full playful gambits and the observations, they were just to get you moving so you didn't have to think. Most importantly, so you did not miss out on that opportunity. Mm-hmm. But you practice for the future and you get better faster by repetition in the now.
That's the power of the default opener.
There you go.
Right?
See, you have something. You say smiles. For me, yeah. In the day game, my default opener.
Titanic. I used Titanic yesterday. You know why? Because by the time, because we were deep in conversation, we hadn't seen each other in a little while, right? And we got to the venue, and we were already in the venue, and it was all around us, and we should have been in game mode, but we were just finishing our conversation, you know? And I didn't feel prepared, so that when that set was there, and I was like, what are we, how are we going to work this? We have to go all the way over there to the other side, of, you know, and look weird, and it's like, yeah, let's do that. And we went right around.
There you go. Right?
Excuse me.
Why not skip the opener? Well, anything you say is an opener. It's
and so,
open.
And so, what was I going to talk about? It was lighthearted banter talk to just initiate it. And then it started with the Titanic for me.
Yeah. You know,
that was what I was throwing into.
I was
boring for him because I know he's heard it before.
But what I was talking about,
yes,
the girl having a shit on
an opener.
Having a shit on a golden toilet. You
but
know?
What do you do next?
But being playful.
Oh right, yeah. Have you ever shit in a golden toilet? It's divine.
I always follow. I mean, still have to clean the fucking seat, you know, give it a little bit of wipe and everything. But you know, it's a golden toilet, right?
Right. And so you see the personality gets conveyed when you're doing that on the open. It's known as a current emotional state opener. Your current emotional state of non-needing, non-threatening, playful, even dare I say it, happy.
The eats, yes.
That gets conveyed on the open, so they're not going to be threatened by you continuing the conversation. We missed a few good questions, unfortunately.
We've got a ton popping up on the 3-second rule group, by the way.
I don't know how to define that. Do we say that former students of mine that are good friends of mine that I miss and haven't seen in a long time, that I am so motivated to see my friends again in the States that's where I'm going. I'm here in Europe right now, but you know, we'll talk about that on the next time we actually have our gathering,
so,
because I'd like to tell you guys a little bit what the plan is, and the plan involves many of you. It's one thing to learn through Periscope. It's a whole other thing for me to just say, get your asses down to where we are, because we're doing a series of training weekends that are going to traumatize you. Immense trauma is what's going to happen. You're going to have trauma by having to do a lot of sets and do some crazy things so that you can go through life with less trauma. We're here to help you.
Take the pain out of the game.
I like that.
Are you going to be in Amsterdam? Absolutely.
Absolutely.
That is on our... I believe Alex Wolf will probably mention that in a moment.
Bring up the
Alex Wolf
schedule.
Yeah.
Or we'll do that another time.
Yeah, he's our program manager. He'll tweet. He'll
okay,
list.
Okay, well, never mind.
But it's in June, Amsterdam. It's a big one. We're both going to be there.
Yeah.
So it's but that one is filling up fast because that is our main one. While everybody's coming together.
Well, here's the quick pitch to that. Guys, a bunch of pickup artists are going to Amsterdam. Some of them are really good at what they do. And if you are okay and want to become better, this may be your third time, because I know some of you have taken boot camps more than once, then we're going to Amsterdam. We've done that before. We're going to do it again. It'll be beautiful weather. That's going to be pretty much assured by mm-hmm. the universe.
I bring weather with me. Don't worry about
right?
weather.
And it's going to be intense. There's going to be a lot of sets to open. You're going to learn the ropes. You're going to learn not just how to open, but how to actually demonstrate higher value without it coming off as bragging.
Amsterdam.
You're going to also learn how to disqualify yourself from being considered a potential suitor, which buys you more time to DHV, so that you can then start to qualify her. Do you know how to qualify a girl to actually do a high value male behavior, such as have that group come join you for a moment, grab a seat, and you start asking her questions that get her to invest in you, but don't open that way. So there's also the structure to pick up, right? For solid game, from meet to beginning a sexual relationship, there's a series of these natural phases. What we want to do is not only tell you what the phases are, but give you the objective of each phase so that using the material that we give you and the knowledge of how to build your own material, you can meet the objective of each phase to get the girl. And the idea here is consistency. I don't want to lose. It's not a matter of the more doors you knock on, the more will open. It's a matter of the more doors you knock on, the more doors you will learn to open. Faster, maybe.
Yeah.
Forgive me, I'm reading as well here. They're all popping up right now. Still chat with Neil. I haven't seen him in a while. Love it, brother. I'm sure he's doing well from what I can see on Facebook so far. You know, his writings are still creeping out into the world and like firm roots that will last forever. What was that all about? Boot camps. I missed that one. Your thesis is on me. That must go over very well with your professors.
That is going to be traumatizing. Yeah.
Yeah. But you get the idea is in order to go through less trauma, you go through trauma.
An interesting point.
All boot camps, are they the same program? In many ways, the program is, my job is to make you great. That's what I do. I build pickup artists. I have a track record of building pickup artists, and I want to build some more superstars. Are you the next superstar? Come tag along, and I'm going to show you the ropes. I'm back in the game. I've been doing multiple cities. I haven't been home in a couple months. Every single day is a fire hose of reality, and I'm preparing myself more than the average person, I think. I've definitely bothered to traumatize myself so that I can have it easier when I head back to Hollywood.
There you go. Price, one of the things Mystery bent my arm on a while was to make sure that we do have expensive boot camps, because the value that we offer is way in advance of anyone else's. There's a lot more time in field, there's a lot more coaches, the ratios are better, the venues and penthouses are better alone. But so the one thing he bent my arm on recently was to make sure that we had something for everyone. So
a richer range,
yeah.
Because
so we even one of the
Facebook
things we did do for those of you a student, speak to Alex Wolf or on our page, post it. There is a code. If you are a student and you're a genuine student, mature either, you get 50% off the seminar. So if there's an early bird and it's 789 and it knocks it down to 489, and you're a student, you could be on a boot camp for like 189, 289. So that's the seminar, 2 or 3 days for like $189 to $289. Guys, that is amazing value. There is something for everyone.
And that way we can meet.
Yeah. And you'll see, guys, sometimes even if you don't go in field, one thing we'll always do in our boot camps, if you can't afford the full in field, okay, that's, guys, who want to fast track the learning. But we'll always, nobody's staying at fucking home. We will get you guys together. We'll put you in some groups with guys of different levels. Not all 10 of you together. If you've got a 40-man seminar, we'll split you up into groups of 5 and we'll send you out there and give you some challenges and some missions to do as well. So everybody goes in the field one way or another and you'll get to come back and listen to the live infielders and the feedback that they get. And you will learn from that as well. So in terms of price, anything from $189 to nearly $3,000, depending on the level of intensity and how quick, how big your budget is, how fast you want to learn, and where your starting point is as well. There's any discount for frequent students? Well, here's the thing. One thing we did on the VIP is anybody who books on any of the programs before the end of the summer is that you will automatically get a Lumini status and 3-second rule for the rest of the year. So that means you can come and attend every friggin' boot camp for the rest of the year for free on the seminar level. And if you want to do the in-field again, you get 50% off. Guys, we are, they're just huge discounts.
Yeah, it just, it takes care, I'm hoping, it takes care of the, whatever it takes to get you into the boot camp, finally, right? Every boot camp, the similarity is you're all going to be traumatized. You're all playing a role of student to teacher just for that weekend. We're all equals on this good planet, and we all have to work our sets as equals in these high-capacity club environments, right?
Will Mystery be on some of those boot camps? Absolutely, yes. The next big one is Amsterdam, and then Bexter and Mystery on the road doing, what's that strange place I couldn't pronounce?
Vilnius?
Riga. Whatever that is. I will personally be doing a routines and gambits, my speciality, a routines and gambits specific one in LA after the Amsterdam. So that's just after the June one on the 17th and 19th, the week after in LA, a routines and gambits specific seminar. I think that's 489 on early bird right now. And the weekend after in New York. So wherever you are, whatever your budget, there is something for everyone. My request of you guys.
Future is in Brazil, yes.
My request of you guys to save you some time and money. We have a system. System, by the way, stands for save yourself time, energy, and money. Mm-hmm. We have a system. If you're going to come on a boot camp, we have a system, okay? And if you choose to follow it, you'll get faster results. If you bring your egos to a boot camp, whatever level, I would suggest in the game, okay, like business, big ego, small bank account, yeah? You need to nullify your egos, okay? And say, I'm coachable. Because if you come along and say, well, I'm kind of sociable anyway, I just want to watch. You're sitting on the outsides. You're sitting on the periphery. Be coachable. Get some feedback. The feedback sometimes sting because a lot of you will come along. You've been in the game for years and you'll come along and think, this is my problem. I need this. I need this. And I need this. He'll watch you for about 5 seconds in field and he'll go, no, that's not your problem, dude. Your problem is X and you'll not like it.
Right.
So be coachable and willing to get the feedback and you will grow so much faster. So if you're going to come in the boot camp, be coachable, okay? Be willing to come along, okay?
You can already think you're a coach. I mean, this is a reach.
You've had coaches from other companies, man.
Exactly, coaches from other companies.
He was sneaking along trying to find out what we were up to.
Right.
And they got some feedback and they were not happy and they insisted. And
As opposed to, let's all eat humble pie. We'll all get good at this game together. I'm not making cookie cutter pickup artists here. Everyone's an individual. We're all going to reach deep down into your own personal history and grab your real true you so that you can convey something compelling and truthful to your girls. It's not about just canned material, right? Canned material will help. It'll help. They're like training wheels. But guess what? You know, 3 days and 3 nights with Mystery, you know, sorry, brother, you're going to cut those wheels off. I'm going to have you doing things that are going to traumatize you. It's going to scare you. You're going to be doing mixed sets. You're going to be working lots of sets. You're going to be merging groups. You have to. Women of beauty aren't alone. They're in groups. And sometimes you can't go straight into that group in order to get the girl. You're going to have to go into an adjacent set. And get that set onto you, and then merge that forward into a set nearby, the one with the target, right? The target rich one. So how do you have the guts to do that? There's something really, really positive about the boot camp experience. There's a camaraderie.
Changed my life.
Yeah, you know, you're still into pickup. You know what I mean? People get into pickup. I mean, you become pickup. Pickup is you. You are pickup. You know, this is your art form. This isn't something you just dilly-dally at. This is your life, brother.
It's an art. It's a skill. You know?
And he's exceptionally skilled. I've seen it time and time and time again. Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah,
thank you.
Really, it's powerful. God's amongst men. Okay, well, I don't know what to say other than thank you for that. There's room at the top for everyone.
See, the thing about the boot camps is, I'm interested in a lot of the questions that are being asked, like Sam, for Christ's sake, and I know you're coming. There were guys, another Sam on there, Gordon,
okay.
Groden or something. There are questions that are being asked there that are like, I'm not being disrespectful, guys, when we're like, really? It's because seriously, some of you can find $189 to at least be on the seminar. By the way, one thing about 3-second rule boot camps, like unlike others, we don't just stand and deliver at you. We'll stand you up after 45 minutes, we'll practice, we'll role play, we'll give you feedback. So everybody
real
gets
world training. Like, this isn't just we're now going to pull out the presentation.
No.
This is getting you for real up to speed in a game we fucking love.
Right.
There's a lot of beautiful women. There's always extra girls going spare, believe it or not. We want you to be fucking cool and get the girl.
Locked, cocked, loaded. So the questions you're asking, they will be solved in one bootcamp. If I could give you any bit of advice and you want to change the game, find some people who are already good at what you're trying to achieve. When I went in a stage of my life, without going into the history of it, when I knew I didn't have any game, I didn't have any social skills, I was in a new area, I had to start again, I found the best in the world at the game. When I wanted to have more influence in my sales and everything, I found a guy called Jordan Belfort, way before the film Wolf of Wall Street became famous. And I got on their master training program. I got on the best that my budget can buy, and I got good at it. When I wanted to learn about personalities, I found Andy Lothian and people who are great at Jungian typology. When I wanted to get good at network marketing, I found the people like Jose Arden and Holt. You go and find the fucking best of what they do, then you stop wasting time. Because I guarantee the guys who have no game, you are going to invest way more than $189 chasing the wrong type of woman for the rest of your bloody lives.
Yeah, you're going to one day blow thousands of dollars on champagne.
Be there.
On a bottle. Just in the hopes that you're going to impress the girl, you're going to lose the girl to someone who didn't buy a bottle, but came in anyway, threw a couple girls into your bottle table, you know, occupied you, snagged your bottle and snagged your girl, gave you a bunch of sevens for your nine, right? All that can happen if you're just not cognizant of social dynamics, right? Of pickup. We're going to show you the ropes of that. If you're going to come out to a boot camp weekend, it will change your life. That's a promise.
Freakonomics, you guys are in a circle of the best in the world. Thank you. We do appreciate you. And by the way,
I love
make
you
sure if you guys appreciate Mishimi's time he spent, make sure you leave a couple of thousand hearts. That's you nodding your hands, clapping your hands. That's the currency of Periscope. Make sure, by the way, before you get
the
off here, because
it's the currency of Periscope.
It's always harder after we finish to start copying and pasting the link because you want your wingmen to see this. So right now, iPhone, swipe left to right, click share. Android, up and down, click share, and then they get it straight away. More importantly, follow this because tomorrow we're going to be live around about the same time, I'm not sure. But if you're live, by the way, a tip, keep the same screen name on here as your Twitter. Then other people can find you and follow you and build up a nice camaraderie. Then tomorrow, Mr. will be live. He's got a couple of announcements to make. I am super pumped, and I'm so super pumped, I'm not staying, I need to go get some lube, because I'm so excited. Okay, get that thought out of your head. Okay, so he's got a couple of announcements tomorrow, and we're going to spend more structured time. We've got a lot of questions came in on the 3-second rule group right now, so well done, guys. We're going to take some time to answer those as well. In the meantime, get some dialogue going. If you want to get good at the game, help somebody else. Help another wingman. Help somebody. Don't leave it just to us to respond. Help. And by the way, don't hate. But congratulate. We're not there on these forums to pick holes and say that doesn't work, this works. Help and encourage guys get into the game. It's a hard step to be on a weird pickup forum in the first place. So please help each other and you'll get a good return yourselves. And by the way, Clue, that's the kind of coaches we're looking for.
Well, we got a low battery here.
10%.
We're down always to 10%, enough. But always enough.
So guys, was that value? If it was value, pump the hearts, click share, follow tomorrow. Mr. B will be doing one more tomorrow, some great announcements. Have you enjoyed it? Periscope is different, right?
I love hanging with you. We end up shooting the shit all the time. It feels no different. And now that I can see some of the names, I know their faces, it feels like social gathering. Right?
It's a nice common basis. I just farted. Was that a brain fart or an anal fart?
I love all your hearts and...
We're reading the screen, by the way. By the way, in the replay, if you wonder
tomorrow,
what we're staring
to talk about.
We're reading the screen right now.
Tomorrow there is more to talk about. Tomorrow we are going to discuss your involvement in that which we love.
Good times, good times. Right now, I need a Jaeger in my belly.
Maybe we'll do two, and they'll make love in our bellies. What time tomorrow?
Shit, it's actually that. You guys just got amazing value. Am I right? No, that's an hour wrong. We just had an hour and 15 minutes.
That's right.
So it is.
Thanks.
An hour and a half, an hour and 15 minutes earlier than now. Whatever time zone you're on. Our time zone, Sweden, was 10 p.m., I believe.
In Sweden.
I believe that is...
We're going out.
1 p.m. PST. I believe it is 4 p.m. Eastern time.
I'd like to leave them with one...
Please.
One thought. Tonight, I'd like you to dream about hopping onto an airplane sometime this year and meeting some like-minded individuals who are going to do the same, and taking out an entire floor of a hotel for a long weekend in a target-rich city of our choice. And let's train. Get good. It's as simple as that. Surround yourself with love, gentlemen, and beauty. Don't be desensitized to it, even though you may be accustomed to it. And get out of the house.
Where are we in Stockholm? Absolutely no idea.
We just teleport from place to place.
By tomorrow, our event will be live and up fully.
I'm not sure
on 3secondrule.com/events.
A few more weeks.
And by the end of the weekend, everything will be formalized, the banners, the links, Eventbrite. By the way, do you want a boot camp for free?
In a month or two?
Look at our affiliate program. If you've got people you know that you can help encourage to get them
Please.
There. Affiliate program and pay for use the credits, pay for your own boot camps free, travel the world with us.
Yep.
Be part of the journey.
Very good.
There you go. Guys, much love. We appreciate you. Take care, take action. I know my personal goal was to have 100,000 men find the love of their lives, but find the skills to consistently find, meet, attract, and keep beautiful women. Mm-hmm. The very fact that we have mystery here helps influence there. But make sure you guys go out and help
Toronto.
Each other. Get a wingman, get out of the house. Tomorrow, same time, same place. Take care, take action. Wish I was there, won't be long. You sure will be, Baxter. Love you guys, Canada. Later, guys, bye. You can sit here and watch the strolls for ages. That's what I love about Periscope. It's just nice and casual. And
yeah, exactly. No, absolutely think that it's the future. Because it's fun, easy. You know, you just set it up and you get to interact with your friends from all around the world. You know, some of you are...
Mr. BUA Dave,
some of
doing
us
a great
are brand
job,
new to each other. And meanwhile, some of us have actually had
Matt's
some
to,
adventures.
Amsterdam to join us.
Okay, fair. Yeah, if you're going to come to Amsterdam, when you come to Amsterdam.
Duncan,
for crying out loud, every human being, every man has to go to Amsterdam at least once in his life. Why not this year?
I'll be in Helsinki on Friday.
Helsinki, yes.
I'm flying back to Helsinki. You're welcome, guys. We appreciate you. Do us a favor. Make sure you share and encourage others on Facebook. And we'll be back here tomorrow, same time, same place.
If you have a hard time to see emotions, I think that's all about learning calibration, what indicators of interest and indicators of disinterest are. We can zoom into that more tomorrow if you come back tomorrow and remind me by asking that question again. I think it's a good question.
Missed you when I was a young child. I read your stuff and you scared and inspired me.
Okay, that's good to hear.
It's nice.
I didn't mean to scare you, buddy.
Hey guys, pleasure.
Okay.
Take care.
We're out of here.